get up, get up, get up, get up, get up! Yes, it hurts, but Jesus is the mender of broken hearts. Yes, it's confusing, but Jesus makes the crooked places straight. Yes, a lot of time has gone by, but Jesus is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Stop your weeping, stop your mourning, get out of your feelings. Jesus is here and he's calling you to get up. You gotta put your trust in his hand and get up from that situation. Get up from that moment. Get up from that season, because you are not done. Yes, it died. Yes, it's stinking. Yes, it's lifeless, but there is one who has conquered death, hell, and the grave, and though he has delayed his coming for a season, he is now here, and he just calls your name to get up. Cast down the spirit of the zombie. I ran over to the dictionary to look up zombie, and something quickened in my spirit when I read the definition. The definition is a person given the semblance of life, but mute and willless. I'm talking to some people who have simply been functioning like a robot from day to day, with a memorized routine giving off the semblance of life. But if you be honest, that last blow left you muted and willless. That last no, that last failure, that last mistake, that last rejection left you for dead. We cast down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bring into captivity every thought to the disobedience of Christ. Can I submit to you today prophetically that the greater the problem, the greater the miracle? I said the greater the problem, the greater the miracle. The miracle that Jesus performed for Lazarus was the greatest miracle he had ever performed. It was something the world had never seen. Can I submit to you today that God's delay could be his divine setup for you to do something for and through you that the world has never seen? Do I have any faith walkers? Let me take a sidebar right here and encourage you to get rid of the people around you who are glorying in your weeping. Stop trying to make excuses for them. Stop trying to see it a different way. It is what it is. Holy Spirit has shown you several times, if I can't trust you to carry me when I'm weak and weeping, then I don't need you. I don't need you. That in order to get the miracle, there are some things that you've got to do. The first thing you got to do today is get out of the dark. I went through a season where I struggled with rejection and depression. One thing I learned about the enemy is that in order to keep you bound, he tries to keep you away from the light. He wants to keep you in the dark. What is light? The word of God. Positive people, positive influences, words of knowledge, words of wisdom. We have to remove that hard wall that we placed over our heart. We have to remove that hate. For some of us, the first thing we need to do is remove the stone. We got to remove that hate, and we got to remove that fear. We got to get rid of all those stones that are preventing the light of God from entering our situation. Psalms 119, 105 says, your word is a lamp for my feet and a light to my path. Can I submit to you today that before you can live again, you got to choose to remove the stones? Well, I came with the spirit of a mother on me today, and I'm commanding you to get out of that grave. You don't belong there. There's way too much left for you to do. You are not finished. The work is not complete. Get your behind out of that grave. Your story is not over. Hey, get out of that grave. Get out of that grave. Get out of that grave. You become a product of your environment, hanging out in the dark, surrounded by dead people. Get out of that grave. Get out of that grave. Jesus is on the scene now, and he's about to do his greatest work in your life. I need you to get out of that grave. Get out of that grave. It's not your time yet. You're not through. You are not done. I said, get out of that grave. That is not your place. That's not where you're supposed to be right now. Somebody say, get up out of that grave. In our culture, most times you can tell who a person is by what they wear. But my point is that there is a direct correlation between who you are and what you wear. That's why I got confused. I get confused at the girls who are half naked all over social media pages, but get offended when someone comments a sexual comment. Oh, I'm sorry, I was misled by your uniform. Police police wear what they wear so you can recognize them if you're in trouble. Nurses wear what they wear so you can recognize them if you're sick. What are your clothes telling people you do? In this scripture, Lazarus had gotten up from the grave, but he was still wearing the clothes that were symbolic of where he had been. Get out of those grave clothes. Get out of those. If we be honest, some of us have been out of the grave for a while, but we never took off the clothes. Some of us have been oppressed by that zombie spirit, but we break its hold today. The Bible says that there was linen wrapped around his hands and his feet, and a cloth was wrapped around his mouth. Can I tell you today that today is the last day that you will walk in that throw in the towel, it's over for me mentality. You are no longer being held hostage. I declare that those fears, those failures, those heartbreaks that have held your praise hostage have to let you go today. I came for those of us who have been showing up every Sunday and Tuesday, singing in the choir, leading worship on the worship team, greeting at the door, but still wearing grave clothes. Grave clothes that are designed and purposed to mute your praise. You want to lift your hands, but it feels like there's weights keeping you bound. You want to leap and dance, but it feels like there are weights holding you down. You want to shout, but it feels like there's a mute on your praise. Not after today. Can I tell you that one word from Jesus will set you free forever? Get out of those grave clothes. Get out of those grave clothes and open up your mouth and shout so the devil will know that you are alive. And he's got to give you back your stuff. And if we be honest, there are some people in the same way. You've been thinking, but Jesus, I told you it was going to fall apart. Jesus, I prayed for you to intervene. I asked you to kill him. I declare that every parent-child relationship that's been dead, we command it to get up and live. Every business idea that failed, we command it to get up and live. Every marriage that's on the rocks, we command it to get up and live. This is a hard one right here. This is a hard one right here. Because some of us tried to die when they died. Some of us chose to die when they died. But we break that spirit today. Some of us got stuck where they died. Some of us got stuck where they died. And today is your resurrection. God does all things well. God does all things well. Some of y'all got to get rid of those stones. They did it. It hurt. Nobody's denying that. They did it and it hurt. Nobody's denying that, but you gotta bring those walls down because those walls are preventing. God uses people to cause breakthrough in your life. And some of us have been turning away God-sent people because of what somebody else did to us 2 years ago. You gotta bring those stony hearts down. You gotta break it up, y'all.
Get up.